Welcome to the Philippine Molar Show. This is Autofocus. I'm Ray Louis Gamboa. Here's a menu of some of our features on this edition of your electronic magazine, exclusive to the automobile and its industry.
Starting off with reviews of two vehicle models presently in the local market, a 9-seater MPV from Maxus, the 2019 G10 1.9 DSL AT, and a luxury van from Toyota, the 2018 Alphard 3.5 LAT. We'll also have a glimpse of some of the latest automobile models and concept cars from around the world. This week, we have the 2019 Audi A1 City Carver and the 2020 Cadillac XT5, plus a feature-to-feature comparison of two subcompact SUVs, the 2018 Ford EcoSport and the 2019 Kia Sportage. Together with the latest news and developments in the local auto industry, we shall have the recently held immersion of the Philippine Motoring Media at the GAC's major plants in China on our special feature.
The next 60 minutes is all about the automobile. This is Autofocus, and we'll be right back after this short break.
To expect high performance from Phoenix Fuels.
We made it!
Now with Pulse Technology, delivers enhanced power and acceleration to make every trip come alive. Every time I'm on the road, I can also expect high performance from Phoenix Fuels.
We made it!
Now with Pulse Technology, delivers enhanced power and acceleration to make every trip come alive.
Suzuki, all new Eltiga.
Life is beating fast. Find what you're waiting for.
Seven-seater in style. All new Eltiga debut.
Part of the 2019-2020 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to www.autofocus.com.ph/AFPCA2019. Then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2019-2020 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2019. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards will win. You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the automobile show. We start this edition of your electronic magazine with a review of one of the latest automobile models from Maxus. The center of this car review is a vehicle that made waves when it first arrived in the country, simply for the fact that it's fresh and it's something that offers more than a typical MPV does. We're talking about the new Maxus G10. Find out more about it here. Watch this.
Basing on the exterior design of the Maxus G10, it could be easy to say that it is just another China-built car, but not until you look closer. It exudes a modern and clean look, one that is fitting for an MPV. Up front, these projector halogen headlights take on the spotlight. In addition, front and rear fog lights are also present to provide more visibility for the driver when needed. Over at the rear, you will find a set of LED tail lights. Moreover, the dual sliding doors make it easier for passengers to go in and out of the G10. It's also worth mentioning that these sliding doors make the G10 considered as a minivan. Other exterior features of the G10 include front intermittent plus rear wiper, and electrically adjustable exterior mirror with side turn lamp. Top it all off with 16-inch alloy wheels, and the G10 is ready to go. Meanwhile, inside, being a 9-seater MPV, the G10 offers a generous amount of space for the passengers. For one, the four captain seats in the second and third rows are comfortable for the passengers to sit on during long drives across cities and rural roads. They are also available with recline and slide options. The last row, on the other hand, comes with a bench seat that can seat three passengers and is available with 60-40 configuration. The seats are wrapped in leather fabric material. More about the seats, the driver's seat comes in 10-way configuration, while the front passenger power adjust seats comes in 4-way. The interior of the G10 is likewise filled with features for added convenience, such as cruise control, driver and front passenger power windows, front and rear reading lights, 220-volt power supply, and front and rear air conditioning system, which keeps everybody cool and fresh during road trips. 4-spoke leather multifunction steering wheel is also available for the driver's convenience. For the infotainment system of the G10, a 7-inch touchscreen radio that's available with USB and Bluetooth connectivity. Sound is enjoyable through 6 speakers that wrap around the corners of the G10. Now let's take a closer look at what's under the hood of the G10. The G10 is powered by a 1.9-liter Euro 4 CRDI turbo engine that is capable of giving out 150 horsepower and 350 Nm of torque. The engine is mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission. Meanwhile, all the noises and vibration is handled by the suspension setup of the G10, comprised of a Pearson at the front and a 5-link coil spring at the rear. This setup makes the G10 ready for any condition. When it comes to safety and security, the G10 is loaded with features that ensure nothing less. Available safety and security features are anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution, ISOFIX, 3-point seatbelt on all seats, front and rear parking sensors, reverse parking camera, immobilizer, and 6 airbags. The all-new Maxus G10 9-seater is available at 1,680,000 pesos.
That was all about the Maxus G10, a newcomer indeed, but not one to miss out. The latest auto industry news and developments right after this break.
Motul is the most trusted motor oil of the top teams competing in some of the world's most grueling race competitions, the WRC, the WTCC, and the Japan GT. Motul is the only 100% fully synthetic motor oil in the market. It has antioxidation properties that prevent premature thickening and aging due to thermal stress and guarantees total engine protection. For more information about Motul engine oils, visit www.motul.com.ph or visit Autoplus Sports Zentrium located along EDSA, across White Plains.
Ah, the things that make my day. My mini-me. My kind of jam. My passion. My blend of coffee. My inspiration. That's all good. With the all-new Vios. My Vios. My drive.
Ako po si Michael Caliwag, 12 taon ng patrol crew para sa NLEX Esitex. Bilang patrol crew, handa akong marap sa anumang di nasaang sitwasyon. Naalala ko pa noon, 2009, Bagyong Ondoy. Papatrol kami sa NLEX nang may nakita kami isang pamilya na natrap sa bubong. kahit kailangan magpatrol, nagdesisyon kami na sagapin at iligtas sila. Kami ang NLEX SETEX Patrol Crew, paagapay at katuwang nyo sa mas maayos na paglalakbay.
Welcome back to AutoFocus, and we now have the latest auto industry news.
AutoNation Group has officially unveiled the all-new Mercedes-Benz B-Class, the second vehicle to receive an update following the A-Class in 2018. Retaining its practical and relaxed character, the all-new Mercedes-Benz B-Class puts emphasis on a more dynamic and agile drive than its predecessor while offering greater comfort and space. The all-new B-Class also sports the Mercedes-Benz User Experience, or the MBUX, which elevates the connection between car and driver to a personal level. When it comes to design and styling, the all-new B-Class has redefined its relaxed and practical look with a sportier profile. The new B-Class also comes with state-of-the-art safety features, elevating it from its segment. Scania, distributed by BJ Mercantile, has officially brought the new truck generation to the Philippine market. The new truck generation has been designed and engineered to give fleet owners greater total operating economy and profitability, as well as lower CO2 emissions. According to Scania, the new truck generation has been developed with a number of overall features in focus: fuel economy, driver environment, safety, optimum use of interior space, and maximum reliability.
It took Scania 10 years to develop this or new generation. There's a lot of upgrading that was done on the cab itself. It is more aerodynamic. There is a lot of changes done in the engine, which makes it even more fuel efficient. Before, Scania is already considered to be a very fuel efficient truck, and now with the new engine, it's even more fuel efficient. And there's a lot more changes actually that came with it.
In addition to enhancing the performance of the vehicle, Scania made the interior of the new truck generation comfortable and functional. Drivers can now drive more safely with a better view of the road due to a lower instrument panel and optimized A-pillars combined with the positioning of the driver 6.5 mm closer to the windscreen and 20 mm towards the side. Moreover, the new truck generation has optional features like rollover side curtain airbags, which can potentially reduce fatalities from rollover accidents by up to 25%. Together with seatbelt use, rollover side curtain airbags are a crucial safety feature in preventing serious injury to the driver. It also features a more robust monocoque structure with high tensile steel, engineered in collaboration with Scania's sister company, Porsche Engineering. The new truck generation also has other reliable safety and security features.
At the end of the day, aside from fuel economy, fuel efficiency, I think it's the relationship that we have with our customers. A truck is a truck. There's so many different brands of trucks. There's so many different types of trucks. But without us taking care of the customers, trying to understand their needs, the truck is, it's just a unit. It's nothing, right? So I think, you know, it's the people behind the scenes who actually make this brand work.
SMC Asia Car Distributors Corporation has announced the availability of the first ever BMW X7 in the country. As presented by SMC Asia Car Distributors, the latest and largest model in the BMW X lineup brings a fresh sensation of space to the luxury segment, attributed to the top-class design of its interior and its state-of-the-art equipment features. Moreover, the advanced powertrain and chassis technology of the X7 ensures off-road prowess, excellent ride comfort, and agile on-road handling, which is necessary in sports activity vehicles. Adding the BMW X7 to its portfolio forms part of the BMW Group's ongoing model offensive in the luxury segment, which is itself a key element in the company's number one next strategy. Suzuki Auto Philippines has closed the first half of 2019 on a high note, posting 14% sales growth over the same period last year and climbing to the sixth spot in the local automobile industry ranking and fifth place in the CAMPI, or the Chamber of Automotive Manufacturers of the Philippines Incorporated ranking. Suzuki says that this is attributed to its top-selling vehicles such as the new Ertiga, Swift, Celerio, Desire, and Vitara, which collectively contributed 77% to total Q1 2019 sales.
One of the big contributions for this year is Ertiga. We launched it January, and after that we got very good feedback from the market, and we think it is well accepted in the market. And second one is, I think it is the Swift, and following that Celerio or Desire or Vitara we have. So that is the very much contribute to our achievement.
Moreover, Suzuki is looking forward to a continued strong growth in the succeeding months with more targeted marketing strategies. Besides continuous efforts to bring the vehicles closer to the target markets through product displays and test drives, Suzuki reinforces its presence in the transport scene through active campaigns and promotions, including for those in the transport vehicle service ecosystem.
Autofocus, the country's premier automobile news and features electronic magazine, takes another short break. Stay with us. I'll be right back.
The things that make my day. My mini-me. My kind of jam. My passion. My blend of coffee. My inspiration. That's all good. With the all-new Vios. My Vios. My drive.
Motoring Today is now on the web. Watch this episode or other past episodes of the country's longest-running motoring program any time of the day by logging on to our website, motoringtoday.ph. Motoring Today is now online, just a click away.
Suzuki, all new Ertiga.
Life is beating fast. Find what you're waiting for.
Seven-seater in style. All new Ertiga debut.
Be part of the 2019-2020 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to www.autofocus.com.ph/AFPCA2019. Then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2019-2020 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2019. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards will win. You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Welcome back to this edition of Autofocus, the country's premier automobile TV and online magazine. Here's Head to Head, our feature-to-feature comparison of the latest automobile models belonging to the same category. In this Head to Head, we will see a bumper-to-bumper comparison of two nameplates that are both up to offer Filipinos a quality drive. It's none other than the Ford EcoSport and the Kia Sportage. See what they got here.
Let's start off with the respective powertrains of our featured vehicles. Under the hood of the EcoSport Titanium is a powerful 1.0-liter turbocharged inline-3 EcoBoost unit that gives out 123 horsepower and 170 Nm of torque. These generous figures are paired up with a 6-speed automatic transmission. This engine layout is what makes it the Titanium. Meanwhile, the Sportage runs on a R2.0-liter common-rail direct-injection diesel engine that is capable of producing 185 horsepower and 400 Nm of torque. This engine is mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission with Shiftronic and Shift Lock. Engine-wise, apart from the figures, the difference between the EcoSport Titanium and the Sportage lie on their respective drive trains. The former is available with front-wheel drive, while the latter features a rear-wheel drive. More on the oily bits, the suspension setup of the EcoSport Titanium is comprised of a McPherson with coil spring at the front and a torsion beam with stabilizer at the rear. Meanwhile, for the Sportage, it is equipped with a McPherson strut at the front and a multi-link with high-performance damper at the rear. Let's take a closer look at the exterior features of our two cars here. The exterior look of the EcoSport is one that resembles other Ford models as it looks traditional, although it also boasts the brand's new design language. For one, the front fascia makes the car look sportier than it has ever been. The grille houses these redesigned fog lights and headlights. At the sides, you will find the subtle curves that add emphasis to the EcoBoost Titanium's body. Over at the rear, there's nothing much going on aside from the usual. Other recognizable exterior features of the EcoSport are these unique 8-pillars which create curves at the bottom. They are obviously positioned to highlight the striking edges of the car's hood, giving it a sporty vibe. Additionally, its exterior is made more exciting with these 17-inch alloy wheels. On the other hand, here's the Sportage boasting a bold, rugged look. The front fascia is highlighted by its trademark tiger grille that carries the projector-type LED fog lights. Just a little below, you will see that Kia did some reshaping on the Sportage's bumper corners. These 17-inch alloy wheels complete the overall exterior look of the Sportage. Other exterior features of the Sportage include a front and rear skid plate exclusively for the GT line, and a rear defogger as well as a rear spoiler. It's time to take a tour of the respective interiors of the EcoSport and the Sportage. Hopping on in the EcoSport, you will be greeted by an all-black material. From the dashboard down to the seats, everything is wrapped in black leather. The cabin offers ample space for the driver and passengers, and there's even extra space for luggage if it's going to be a long adventure with family or friends. Moreover, the panoramic sunroof is present, given that this is the top-of-the-line variant and is the only one that has it. The EcoSport is also loaded with features that target added convenience, such as a 3-spoke steering wheel, push-start button, auto headlights, power windows, parking sensors, and reverse camera. But the real showstopper is the infotainment of this model. Since this is the top-of-the-line variant, it comes equipped with an 8-inch Sync 3 touchscreen integrated with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Audio is courtesy of 7 speakers. On the other hand, the inside of our Sportage variant here is likewise wrapped in leather. From the seats, the steering wheel, and every part of the car, like the center console. For the other variants, they get the standard fabric material. The Sportage provides a generous amount of space as well, enough for all passengers to remain comfortable during the drive. For added cargo, the rear seats are foldable, so that's a plus. For added convenience, the steering wheel comes with tilt and telescopic adjust configuration, and cruise control comes standard in all variants of the Sportage. Also, the air conditioning comes with dual full auto climate control. For the infotainment system, all Sportage variants come equipped with a 3.5-inch LCD display that is available in AM/FM, CD, MP3, aux-in, and USB port, and is iPod-ready. Sound is enjoyable, courtesy of 6 speakers. When it comes to safety and security, here's what the EcoSport and the Sportage offers. EcoSport Titanium is equipped with Ford's standard features such as anti-lock brake system with electronic brake force distribution, stability control, ISOFIX, and 6 airbags. Meanwhile, the Sportage comes with dual and side curtain airbags, anti-lock brake system, security alarm, immobilizer, and stability control, among others.
Those were the Ford EcoSport, EcoBoost Titanium, and the Kia Sportage GT line. Two nameplates that stand uniquely on their own and have what it takes to bring you to good adventures. More about the automobile here in AutoFocus as we usher in our segment featuring the autos of the world, spotlighting concept cars as well as newly launched and about to be launched automobile models from around the world. For your exciting viewing on this edition of your automobile electronic magazine, we have the 2019 Audi A1 City Carver. That's Watch This.
Prospective drivers of the already innately city-friendly Audi A1 will soon have the option to make their car look even more urban-ready by choosing a new City Carver specification that takes a tougher stance. New City Carver versions of the A1 will be available to order in the UK in conjunction with 30 TFSI and 35 TFSI petrol engines from September and will begin arriving with customers in the autumn. The design of the 4.04-meter Audi A1 City Carver is based on the A1 Sportback, but it has a more muscular look achieved primarily through wheel arc enhancements and redesigned sills in a contrasting color, underbody protection in a stainless steel finish, and raised suspension giving around 4 centimeters of additional ground clearance for easier entry and better visibility. Its large octagonal single frame is also reminiscent of the Audi Q models and surrounds a strongly sculpted honeycomb insert painted in matte black. Two characteristic slots above the grille differentiated from the A1 Sportback. At the rear, a new-look bumper echoes the robust look of the front end. The A1 City Carver mirrors the A1 Sportback with a generous interior and a luggage compartment with a 335-liter capacity. The same applies for standard equipment is concerned, the City Carver starts with larger 17-inch alloy wheels and features a roof-edge spoiler normally reserved for the S-Line versions. As well as the digital interior functionality, its specification includes full LED headlights with dynamic rear turn signals, air conditioning, the Audi Drive Select dynamic handling system, and assistance technology such as cruise control, Audi PreSense front with pedestrian and cyclist recognition, lane departure warning, and hill hold assist.
NLEX Viaje Tips presents Healthy Road Trip. It's time for that much-awaited vacation, but here are a few things to watch out for. Sitting for long periods of time can form blood clots in your body, like in the legs. To avoid that, stop for a quick break, get up, and move around to get your blood pumping. Car air conditioners speed up dehydration, so make sure to drink water frequently. Lastly, while driving, protect your eyes from the sun by wearing UV-blocking sunglasses. And for a smoother trip up north, you can now drive all the way to your destination with one RFID. Get your Easy Trip RFID sticker now.
Be it fine dining, a romantic garden wedding, a relaxed casual meal, or an important business event, Ilustrado is the place to go. Aside from its famed paella, the Ilustrado restaurant, which is located within the history-laden walled city of Intramuros, is also the favorite destination of food gourmands for its famous callos and lengua and other classic gustatory offerings. Ilustrado restaurant, only for the foodies.
Welcome back to Autofocus. Our special feature is next. It has been the goal of GAC Motor Philippines to bring its brand and roster of quality vehicles closer to Filipinos ever since it arrived in the local market. Aside from launching its lineup of products, one of the company's first major steps towards this goal is flying out members of the local motoring media to China. Here's what happened during the group's visit to the two major plants of GAC Motor in Guangzhou. Hey!
GAC Motor Philippines gave members of the motoring media a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to tour GAC Motor Company's two major plants in Guangzhou, China, namely the New Energy Plant and the Regular Plant, respectively.
One is the new electric energy plant where they are producing the electric cars and hybrid. And the other is the regular plant where they do the combustible cars. Both of them are really state-of-the-art workshop and they are very impressed with what they have seen.
In the New Energy Plant, the team toured the car exhibition area where they got to see up close the most important GAC NE model in Zone C, the Ion S. It's the world's first custom-made long-range AI-based EV, which combines five features of long battery life, large space, high intelligence, good looks, and in-depth customization. The group was able to see up close how the vehicle assembly area works. This is where the stamping, welding, painting, and general assembly take place. The welding area specifically covers an area of 24,000 square meters with an intended capacity of 150,000 units per year. It is divided by production processes into the floor, sidewall, body, door, and assembly production areas. Meanwhile, the General Assembly Workshop is 400 meters long and 100 meters wide, and it houses 116 sets of production equipment. According to the one-time design-build principle, its design capacity is 150,000 units per year as well. According to GAC, they are confident that the use of electric energy will benefit the Philippine market as it promotes green energy.
We believe that in Legazo Motors that the electric energy is a very exciting product that which we should be bringing into the Philippines. As you can see, the whole world now has been quite conscious with green energy. And not only that, with the electric cars in the Philippines, we will be able to showcase that the green energy can be more efficient and can save our environment at the same time.
That was our special feature on the recent visit and immersion of the local motoring media to GAC Motors' two major plants in Guangzhou, China. We hope you enjoyed. And up next is another exciting feature on Autos of the World. This time around, the 2020 Cadillac XT5. Let's watch this.
Cadillac's global best-selling XT5 is revamped for 2020 with a new turbocharged engine, enhanced technologies, and revised design cues that coalesce in distinctive trims that offer customers greater choice in matching this luxury crossover to their personality. With more than 40 updates, the 2020 Cadillac XT5 raises the bar, delivering an exhilarating driving experience paired with the sense of solidarity and functionality of an SUV. The XT5 joins the all-new XT6 three-row crossover in the recently launched segment-topping XT4, along with the iconic Escalade, to give Cadillac one of the industry's freshest lineups of luxury crossovers and SUVs. The 2.0-liter turbo twin-scroll turbocharger and unique 3-step sliding camshaft help the engine optimize performance across the RPM band for a greater feeling of on-demand power at all speeds. It is rated at an SAE-certified 237 horsepower and 350 Nm of torque.
The things that make my day. My mini-me. My kind of jam. My passion. My blend of coffee. My inspiration. That's all good. With the all-new Vios, my drive.
Part of the 2019-2020 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to www.autofocus.com.ph/AFPCA2019. Then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2019-2020 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2019. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards will win. You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Suzuki, all new Eltiga.
Life is beating fast. Find what you're waiting for.
Seven-seater in style. All-new Eltiga debut.
Welcome back. We have more cars for you to know and appreciate here in Autofocus as we have our second car review this week. A vehicle that has a sleeker design and is equipped with more advanced features compared to its predecessor. That is the 2018 Toyota Alphard. Find out what makes it stand out in this car review. Watch this.
A vehicle that has a sleeker design and is equipped with more advanced features compared to its predecessor, that is the 2018 Toyota Alphard. Let's find out what makes it stand out from the crowd. First things first, the engine. Under the hood of the Toyota Alphard is a 3.5-liter V6 engine that now produces more power and torque. It gives out 296 PS of power and 361 Nm of torque, and is mated to an 8-speed automatic transmission, which used to be a 6-speed automatic. This engine layout makes the Alphard powerful when it comes to conquering the road. For the suspension, it comes with the same McPherson strut with stabilizers at the front and a new double wishbone with coil spring at the rear. Meanwhile, both front and rear brakes are operated by disc brakes, so there's no problem putting the car to a stop. Let's now take a closer look to the exterior details of the Alphard. Although the size is still the same, there's a number of features that don't look familiar, and that's definitely because it is exactly what Toyota's goal is in launching the new Alphard, to make it look different from what the public is used to. Starting with the front fascia, the Alphard comes with a bigger grille and is further highlighted by this new set of headlights. There's a notable change in the emblem as well, as the Alphard now bears its own logo. Meanwhile, the rear houses this new set of signal lamps, an additional detail that complete the whole look. Overall, Toyota did a great job giving the Alphard a facelift, making their luxury minivan a sight to behold on the road. It's now time to hop in the new Alphard. Inside, the leather-clad captain seats with Automan will effortlessly catch anyone's attention. Just like with its predecessor, these are power-adjustable seats as well. The majority of the Alphard's interior is wrapped in a premium wood grain trim, complemented by matte chrome and black piano wood inserts. We could stop here and decide right away that the interior of the Alphard screams luxury and comfort. But more on the topic of comfort, the Alphard comes with enough, if not more, legroom for the passengers in the second and third row.
Moreover, the Tri-Zone Automatic Climate Control is a staple feature in the Alphard. Also, for a 7-seater minivan, the Alphard's interior doesn't look and feel packed, despite the number of features and details it comes with. The buttons are placed strategically and are within reach. For the infotainment system, the Alphard is equipped with the standard touchscreen display and navigation. It comes with the standard 2 DIN 8 speaker sound system that is available in AM, FM, CD, DVD, MP3, AUX, USB, and Bluetooth connectivity, among others. The Alphard doesn't also compromise safety and security. It boasts important features such as 7 airbags, hill start assist, stability, traction, and vehicle dynamic controls, brake assist, and anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution.
That was the 2018 Toyota Alphard, proving it goes beyond the facelift. And that's Autofocus this week. And on behalf of my dad, Butch Gamboa, we hope you have found this edition of your Automobile Electronic Magazine informative as well as entertaining. You can also check us out on our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. Until the next time, this has been Ray Louis Gamboa.